is nothing to say. If among you are those who wish to get somewhere, let them leave at any moment. What we require is silence. But what silence requires, or what silence requires, is that I go on talking. Give any one thought a push, it falls down easily. But it's the pusher and the pushed produce that entertainment called a discussion. Shall we have one later? Or we could simply decide not to have a discussion. Whatever you like. But now there are silences, and the words help make the silences. I have nothing to say, and I am saying it. And that is poetry as I need it. The space of time is organized. We need not fear these silences. We may love them. This is a composed talk, for I'm making it just as I make a piece of music. It is like a glass of milk. We need the glass and we need the milk. Or again, it is like an empty glass into which at any moment anything may be poured. As we go along, who knows? An idea may occur in this talk. I have no idea whether one will or not. If one does, let it. Regard it as something seen momentarily, as though from a window while traveling. If across Kansas, then of course, Kansas. Arizona is more interesting, almost too interesting, especially for a New Yorker who is being interested in spite of himself in everything. Now he knows he needs the Kansas in him. Kansas is like nothing on earth, and for a New Yorker, very refreshing. It is like an empty glass. Nothing but wheat, or is it corn? Does it matter which? Kansas has this about it. At any instant, one may leave it, and whenever one wishes, one may return to it. Or you may leave it forever and never return to it. For we possess nothing. Our poetry now is the realization that we possess nothing. Anything, therefore, is a delight, since we do not possess it, and thus need not fear its loss. We need not destroy the past. It is gone. At any moment, it might reappear. Seem to be, and be, the present. Would it be a repetition? Only if we thought we owned it. But since we don't, it is free, and so are we.